career development and job satisfaction. This course is brought to you by Gilad James Mystery School. Learn more at giladjames.com. Job satisfaction and employee engagement. Job satisfaction is considered as the amount or degree of gratification and contentment that an employee fosters towards his/her overall job, factoring into that equation his/her satisfaction with the job itself, the peers at the job, the supervisors, and the policies at work. Various research studies have highlighted the importance of focusing on the issue of employee job satisfaction, as it plays a critical role in overall firm success or demise. Additionally, the importance of employee job satisfaction has been largely emphasized in the literature because of its positive effect on employee job performance. The productivity of the workforce, in any organization, is a major driver which leads to achieving organizational goals. This stresses on the importance of further focusing on job satisfaction as an essential concern for family firms and large corporations equally. Recently, organizations have focused on maximizing productivity in order to maintain their competitive stance and better deal with emerging trends such as globalization. Nowadays, the general direction which firms take when expanding is into international markets that reveal potentially rewarding new opportunities. However, whether it is answering to customer needs or developing and growing on its own, a company needs to ensure that its workforce is as productive as possible, and in order for the workforce to perform at its utmost productivity, employees must feel a satisfaction relating to the nature of the work they are performing. In order to achieve this ultimate productivity, it is suggested that organizations should define major issues that might actually affect the level of employee job satisfaction and attempt to tackle these occurrences which hinder an employee's level of satisfaction at work. For instance, Inoue discusses in his writings how job satisfaction is related to performance. The results of his analyses showed how an employee's motivation towards being productive at work will increase the more the employee is satisfied with the job, leading to the achievement of the overall organizational goals. If not, the employee will be demotivated, and in turn, this will impact the overall achievement of the predetermined organizational goals. Furthermore, whenever the factors in the organizations that affect employees' motivation are managed, better employee outcomes and performance are created. Therefore, the more the employee motivation, the better the outcome of employee performance. This sheds light on the highlighted relationship between job satisfaction and employee engagement. Results of multiple studies show that the more engaged the employees are, the higher their job satisfaction is. This is due to the fact that employees who feel engaged at work will have better, more efficient, and more productive working behaviors, attitudes, and motivations. On the other hand, job dissatisfaction can have serious consequences on the productivity of the firm, one of which is employee turnover. Turnover is when the employee decides to leave the organization. Job satisfaction is important for employees to stay in the organization. Understanding generational differences among different generations and their perception of job satisfaction is of huge and utmost importance. Organizations must know what actually satisfies a person to stay in the organization, since a satisfied employee will work for the interest of the organization, which in turn leads to better overall work performance. Moreover, based on the findings of a research study conducted by Acaria, there are four aspects which contribute to the satisfaction of millennials: training, commitment of the organization to developing employees, career development, and career opportunities, job satisfaction and career development. Companies must also consider career development as a new key to retain their employees, especially that in the next 10 years, millennials would be representing the bulk of the workforce. Career development is the ongoing process of learning, developing, and moving towards one's goals. Moreover, career development has its own advantages, one of which is the fact that it reduces turnover and increases employee motivation. Career development is in the interest of all generations, yet it is mostly sought after by the millennials, and thus, it plays a major factor in their job satisfaction. Career development includes extensive training, in specific, with respect to the areas the employee wants to develop. Having mentioned job satisfaction and career development and the importance of the effect of one on the other, it is time to discuss the relationship between these two variables. Career development contains structured, dignified, and deliberate exertion of effort, in order to accomplish a state of evenness between the organization's objectives and strategies and the employee's career goals as well as the progress that he or she seeks. the proper career preparation and career supervision will lead to the best results of career development. McDaniels and Geisbers mentioned that career development is the collection of mental, sociological, informative, corporal, financial, and unplanned factors that are shared to form the career of any targeted employee. Career development depends on the organization's decision to transfer employees from their traditional work, and the tasks that are common to them, to more challenging work that is enriched with initiatives for self-development and organizational effectiveness. An effective career development plan helps the organization to benefit from its internal talent by corresponding the experience and skills gained by the employees and linking them to the organization's needs, while also motivating and engaging the employees to give more effort by the compensation and succession plans given for the sake of career development. Lee mentions that companies who participate in career management are going to enhance their employees' job satisfaction. Gregson mentions that job satisfaction is the state of emotion that the employee feels fulfillment in after his performance management review and experience in the organization. Shea and Bruvold state that job satisfaction is the positive reaction of the employee to different phases of the job. Job satisfaction happens after the employee experiences emotions of self-actualization in his/her career. Career development programs were found to have a positive inspiration on job satisfaction, professional development, and productivity in a research conducted by Chen, Chang, and Yeh. Moreover, in a research study conducted by Shine, it was found that career development plays a major role in employee effectiveness and creativity over the long term. Moreover, a well-organized career development will allow employees to pursue improvements in their career that will actually lead to the employee's job satisfaction. Moreover, Shine adds that employees will have different career developments according to their preferences, goals, and, most importantly, the external factors such as global business changes. Shine elaborates more to state that employees have different work needs at each stage of their career path and organizations should take into consideration the career needs of their employees in each stage to satisfy their career development and increase the organizational effectiveness and cope with its needs as well. Each specific stage of career development has different goals and different mission from the next one. Furthermore, organizations should be responsive and open to career developments of their employees because modernization and improvement is the field where each company differentiates itself from its competitors and, at the end, it is the responsibility of the employee to gain the knowledge through his/her experience when everything is provided to him/her by the organization. Although the managers with the guidance of the Human Resources Department set the career development plan for the employee, each employee enters the company with a career development plan in his/her mind that he or she wishes to obtain through his/her experiences within the organization. In fact, many career plans suggested by the employees are considered by the managers and are accepted to be beneficial for them. Additionally, any company that implements career development plans for its employees will, in fact, reduce its employees' turnover rate. Hoon mentions that career planning, management, and development that are respective with human resources guidance influence employees' job satisfaction. Robin mentions that if there exists a gap in the career needs of the employee, there will be stress and anger between coworkers, which in fact impacts the job satisfaction level in employees. Chen, Chang, and Yeh study in their research the relationship between job satisfaction and the gap that exists between career development programs and career needs. In the case of Taiwan, where organizations are working to increase their competitiveness and become more involved in high-tech production and development, the gaps existed between career development programs and expected career needs of production and development has improved the job satisfaction in R&D employees. However, widening the gaps between career development plans and employee career needs will lower job satisfaction in R&D employees. Moreover, the gap changes in each career stage influences the job satisfaction differently. In addition, as the gap widens, employees that are on the establishment stage of their career will get lower job satisfaction, and those that are on the maintenance stage will get higher job satisfaction than those on any other career stage. Several changes in the company, such as downsizing, right-sizing, and flattening, affect the career development of employees in the company for the future. Moreover, employees are more satisfied with their jobs and give it their best when they sense well-organized developmental career plans that support their development and advancement to reach high levels and learn more through this career path. In addition, career development for employees aids in the competitiveness of the company in the market by addressing the organizational needs of employees when developing them. Companies that implement a person environment theory tend to have the best career development of their employees and foresee employees' needs as much more important in order to know how to improve the interaction of the employee with his work environment. Potgieter, Coetzee, and Ferreira mention in that the person environment fit is essential for the sake of a worker's job embeddedness and career. Moreover, the person environment fit is determined by the employee satisfaction with his position in the company, culture, and work environment. Also, it is determined by the career development and employee expectations. The authors Potgieter, Coetzee, and Ferreira mention that the result of their research that is facilitated by the person-environment fit theory is the embeddedness of employees in their career development, which will help the employee to acquire job satisfaction of his position and career. Thus, accomplishing employees' career needs to develop will play a huge role in the job satisfaction of the employee. Furthermore, hopes for improvements in jobs were increased by 20% when the term career development was initiated. There are specific career counselors in many organizations that are known for career development. Now career counselors are included in the tasks of the Human Resources Development Department. The importance of the link between career development and job satisfaction was attracting the researchers. A link between the two conducts was first detected by Gregson. The results of the research conducted by Pearson and Ananthram are that those organizations that fail to accomplish employee satisfaction will experience a non-stop of employee crisis. Moreover, employees retained in organizations that gave them the opportunity to be engaged in their career development plan. Most importantly is that young employees doing their job and attaining career development make their job more than just a job. Career development boosts the young employees' efforts in the organization and makes them stick to the company. The authors highlighted on the importance of the link between job satisfaction and career development in increasing job retention and boosting effort of employees. Career development will result in job satisfaction and especially in younger employees. Importance and relevance of career development. Career development is a significant path of knowledge management, effort, freedom and evolution to move towards a personally resolute and developing preferred future. Leibowitz and Lee described career development systems as integrated services and procedures that meet the needs of both individuals and organizations. Cheng et al. Posit that career development programs enable HR managers, and their stakeholders to work together to plan, organize, formalize, lead and monitor career programs to develop not only employees' jobs but the whole stage process, attitude, behavior and state of affairs relating to employees' work life. Job satisfaction is influenced by people, supervisors and co-workers in the workplace, compensation and the work environment. Locke defined job satisfaction as the pleasurable or positive emotional state resulting from the overall evaluation of one's job or job experiences. Employee satisfaction can be achieved by making a good career development system and giving an understanding of how important the system is that is designed by the company for managerial and professional employees. We all know that businesses exist to attain high productivity in their working styles and produce a competitive edge in the global economy. To achieve this edge and high efficiency, firms need talented and engaged employees. The role of human resources management becomes even more important than ever in this competitive era. An approach, which is a panacea to this managerial need, is the implementation of career development process. Career development is one such significant practice which enhances the level of employee engagement, which in turn subsequently increases the organizational effectiveness. The purpose of career development is to match the employee's aspirations with the firm's challenges that could result in organizational effectiveness. Organizations that want to attract, motivate and retain employees need to show concern towards employee career development. Abdelnour and Hall stated that organizations can no longer afford to squander valuable human resource assets because employee development leads to corporate development. That the talent generates a lot of company performance and is a source of a competitive advantage, it is important to create conditions for intra-organization movements, internal job posting, and to offer many career management practices such as succession planning, coaching, mentoring, rotation, development plans, individual information on opportunities for career development and others. In order to understand the implementation of career development programs, it is essential to run a survey on the kind of audit to be carried out. This will help in estimating the career development needs of the organization. Organizations' need cannot be satisfied without satisfying individual needs. Understanding the organizational culture and context with defined roles of those implementing needs to be well defined and articulated. Flow and implementation process of career development program. Each individual is different. He or she has different personalities, abilities, needs and desires. Therefore, career planning programs should be based on the segmentation of employees, grouping them more by their needs, rather than hierarchical levels. Managers should create several different career development programs customized for each segmented group and provide development programs based on the assessment of the potential and performance of the employees, keeping in mind the needs and mission of the organization. Having the right resources and support systems would enable in making the process effective based on the outcome of the need and the strategy built. There are a number of initiatives and practices which could give the perspective on the resources and supports. One of the ways which can help is counseling. Counseling sessions are of great help to develop themselves because it provides a path towards achieving career goals. If an employee is in a state of not being able to choose from the options, counseling perhaps would show a positive path. Hare and Kramer suggested that counselors may be involved in team building, consultation with managers, psychological crisis consultations, training in negotiating skills, assessing needs, training trainers, evaluating outside programs, designing, presenting and evaluating training programs, and interviewer training. One-to-one talk brings in a conversation which is even more transparent and can come up sharing more openly, especially those who keep to themselves and slowly lose interest and move out of the organization in time to come if they are not tapped at the right time and a chord is struck in a positive way. In similar lines, mentoring programs give that support which an employee looks towards to discuss and share with his mentor, who is a friend, philosopher, and guide. Corporate mentoring programs reveal much benefit in days to come for the employee. Mentors provide a perspective of leadership. External mentors and so does a coach provide a constructive feedback. According to Savickas and Baker, career psychology is in need of reinvigoration to respond to the challenges of rapid transformation in a postmodern world. Leibowitz and Lee and Brown and Brooks suggested that more research in the area of career development may result in more organizational support. Comparatively, the number of career development services available, there is very little research published on their effectiveness. Secondly, companies' leadership programs chalk out career development plans for an employee. There could be action learning projects chalked out as a career development plan which accelerates his growth and development and at the same time plugs his gaps by working as a member of the project team. Self-directed work course aimed at guiding career planning and analysis of the individual gives a record and shows a document of progress, keeping an individual spirited on his journey of career development. The primary aim of the career planning program is not to help employees lay out a career plan per se, but to help employees in being focused to acquire skills essential for planning their own career. Group workshop is another way which could help employees evaluate their skills, abilities and interests and to formulate development plans. If the organizations arrange training sessions by investing in their employees' career, then the organizations in return acquire the most talented and satisfied workforce. It is a continuous process that gives an employee the set of new skills and sharpens the existing ones. In addition, succession plans and job rotations, vertical or horizontal, enable an employee to see these as opportunities. It is seen as one of the career development activities which is useful in enhancing their knowledge, skills and abilities to improve job performance and adding value to current and future jobs, bringing in a sense of fulfillment and value. Career development should be implemented effectively because it can affect the sustainability of the company. There are even apps today which work on career development. One would say it's a cool tool. WhatFix is an electronic performance support platform that can provide in-app guidance within business applications. Using this platform, talent development professionals can train and support employees at their point of need. However, the contact on a person-to-person keeps an exchange of mind and gives a support to the emotional self. Yet another platform which enables an employee visibility, especially more so in large organizations, is featuring an employee in company's in-house newsletter. This kind of platform creates an image and gives connection in organizations on the availability of a profile which could fit in other engaging roles. The social exchange theory primarily dwells upon feelings of personal obligation, gratitude, and trust. Social exchange theory can be used to predict the outcomes of different management practices. Career development programs provide stimulation and fulfillment at numerous phases of employee development, proactively finding capacity in advance and granting prospects for learning. Senior defines job satisfaction as the extent to which individual needs are met in the work setting. Employee satisfaction can be achieved by making a good career development system and giving an understanding of how important the system is that is designed by the company for managerial and professional employees. Investing in professional development of employees allows differentiation and gaining competitive advantage, as it also increases the level of abilities and knowledge the organization can use to achieve organizational goals. However, good career development can be manifested when it is actualized in day-to-day behavior by all in the organization. Meta-analytic support also exists for the positive relationship between individual career management behaviors and career satisfactions. Today, employees are more conscious about their professional and personal growth. Organizations that do not align themselves to this thought process eventually lose their talented workforce. Traditionally, career was considered to be confined to professionals or those who advance through organizational hierarchy. In terms of today career, it is more appropriately meant to be the lifelong sequence of the role-related experiences of individuals. Employees of today know that they could be out of date if they do not enhance their knowledge and skill. They too would look out for opportunities to upgrade, therefore companies providing the support of career development programs make a huge difference in their engagement and satisfaction in their career life. The flip side is that too much of raising expectations and there being not enough roles could lead to dissatisfaction, and one would then go beyond the frontiers of their own organization. Being straightforward about career options builds trust and rests no false notions. Super referred to the specific stages of exploration, establishment, maintenance and disengagement, noting that individuals have different career development tasks and characteristics at different stages of their careers. You affirms that studies on workplace career programs highlight the fact that the ability of the management to properly plan and manage career programs for employees who work in different job categories may have a significant impact on employee outcomes, especially job satisfaction. It is essential that the practices as per the strategy need to be piloted before we move forth into a full implementation. One looks at career as a life's fulfilling journey. The employee is more concerned about his/her career and personal development and transformation throughout his work life. Ismail et al. Correlate on career development and job satisfaction, as the readiness of management to appropriately plan and manage career programs adequately which assists employees to develop career paths and, as a result, may lead to higher job satisfaction in the organization. Employees need the encouragement, resources, tools and support to envision their futures. It is not necessary that organizations need to provide new app or program, but they do need conversations with managers, coaches or mentors. Even if the salaries are not high, corporates with career development program and experience of job satisfaction exist. Limitations. This study concludes with suggestions for future research. First of all, this study is a more qualitative study of career needs. Future studies could include data through surveys or through longitudinal studies which could result in promising outcomes. In addition, it is also foreseen that the development of valid and reliable measures of career needs is one of the primary challenges for those researchers interested in taking this aspect forwards. Practical implications and conclusion. Grappling with situations and circumstances in the journey of the future of work, change is inevitable and can influence numerous events inside and outside an organization. Seen through the theoretical lens and on-ground practices, the findings added new insights into the circumstances under which employee can work in the process flow articulated implemented by the organization which would influence positively employee satisfaction with organizational retention practices. The contrasting attitudes of acceptance and resistance to change are an increasingly interesting topic in today's global, ever-changing and competitive environment. Career development truly forms an enabler to job satisfaction. If one hops in the bandwagon, the feeling could be comforting in the beginning. One needs to filter the popular demand and peer pressure, rather than to think objectively and assess his own competency, skill and passion, and then take a call. The implication is that individuals will then find their jobs to be more meaningful and enjoyable. It plays a pivotal role in the ecosystem of the entire gamut of development-related processes. Managers should ensure that they frequently review employees' career concerns through formal career discussion and have conversations. It requires alignment of human resource systems like performance management, career development, and succession planning. In addition, it involves establishing an integrated career development system to support current and future business needs with continuous development and upgrade of people. Career development programs should be flexible in order to adapt to the changing economic scenario. The readiness of individuals within organizations and their ability to make an edge are the factors which influence the opportunities in career development. Having career conversations and advancements will enable an employee to be satisfied, will keep them engaged and give them a sense of fulfillment in the journey of employment and work life. It is trusted that this research will inspire further research on the topic, which will align organizational and employee needs. Introduction. We all might have encountered employees at workplaces who drop in every now and then to their fellow colleagues' chamber to gossip, or who absolutely have no sense to dress formally or during occasions, or who have always been pessimistic in their approach toward a solution, or who always communicate aggressively with peers and others depicted through verbal or nonverbal means, or who keep waiting for the deadlines to approach and then begin their work given, or who use unethical means to achieve success faster. These are just the examples of some poor soft skills basically witnessed at workplaces. Thus, if we consider the opposite of these examples, we are actually talking about skills and abilities that refer to as soft skills. These skills are essential to focus for both individual and career development. Literature does not provide any concrete definition of soft skills, rather it offers a list of examples of soft skills for the readers so that they can frame their own interpretation. To create an understanding of soft skills, it must first be accepted that soft skills are commonly used interchangeably with life skills, people skills, interpersonal skills, communication skills, workplace skills, cultural skills, management skills, and employability skills. Whatever the name, it is almost essential that you have to communicate or interact in public at some point or the other. Whether it is presenting your project work, interacting with your bosses, clients or teachers, appearing for group discussions or job interviews, or excelling in the real world, people from all streams need the all-important soft skills. Thus, soft skills can be very much related with personality traits including social and emotional intelligence that directly or indirectly affects our behavior in either developing or decaying relationships. Recent studies claim that soft skills are considered to be one of the most emerging studies in the recent decades and are exceptionally prerequisite chiefly in the domain of workplaces. Literature review. The concept of soft skills originated way back in 1918 when Charles Ribourg Mann in a bulletin of a study of engineering education issued along with other representatives of Carnegie Foundation for the Advancement of Teaching mentioned about the first meeting of the Joint Committee of the National Engineering Studies. In the meeting, many engineers were interrogated pertaining to their skills and abilities considered that are potential in ascertaining success in building engineering profession. Further analysis stated that personal qualities like common sense, ethics, self-competence, and emotional intelligence are universally recognized as being equally important to a professional engineer as are technical knowledge and skill. Later, it was viewed that soft skill as a study is not restricted to only the engineering field. Emerging studies found the relevance of soft skills appeared in various domains like management, IT, education, administration, hospitality, medical, and pharmacy. Trading the application of soft skills at workplaces has gained enough attention, and the need to inculcate these skills into one's personality has become a necessity. Whether you work in the IT industry or manufacturing industry, whether you work in a family business or a multinational corporation, soft skills are those skills that are absolutely essential for success. Furthermore, the significance of soft skills in various areas have also emphasized that there are various kinds of soft skills highly vital and valuable at workplaces. Every day, countless meetings, trainings, and business dealings are carried out at workplaces where people from diverse backgrounds work together for a common purpose through execution of ideas and information in the best possible manner. The role of soft skills at this expository situation carries enormous value. Many authors studying soft skills state that these are essentially people skills, the non-technical, intangible, personality-specific skills that determine one's strengths as a leader, listener, negotiator, and conflict mediator. Alex further elucidates that there is another set of skill known as hard skills that are associated with domain skills or technical skills and that they are way different from soft skills. He clarifies that hard skills are more along the lines of what might appear on one's resume: your education, experience, and level of expertise. In other words, hard skills are the technical abilities that are earned through education, training, and practice in the name of a degree. But a degree is simply not enough today to ensure a successful career. Recruiters today are seeking for work-ready candidates possessing a number of skills required specifically for specific job roles. Hence, it is true that since the growing importance of soft skills is largely accepted, hard skills alone might not be sufficient in order to survive successfully. But the fact that both hard skills and soft skills complement each other is also not false. Soft skills are in fact healthy supporters of communication and performance. They are recognized as connectors that build the gap and bridge relationships among the people at the workplace, leading to better productivity and performance. Soft skills reduce the gaps across various departments in an organization, thus promoting effective communication and performance. Globalization has augmented the changing environment at workplaces that significantly stipulate soft skills, otherwise surviving and sustaining would remain just a distant dream far from reality. Although there are many business guides like Simplicable Hat distinguishes around 87 soft skills under various other subskills like leadership, communication, personal skills, interpersonal skills, and many more, this paper deals with the study of selected soft skills which are critical and must-haves by the employees at workplaces to develop their career. Soft skills at workplaces. Soft skills are familiar terms in the everyday life, in preserving interpersonal relationships, in shaping activities, and in building strategies for success. Its insinuation is predominantly found at workplaces. However, for many leaders at the workplace, soft skills are believed to be unnecessary as they follow a common belief that when people are paid for their work, gratitude does not carry any stance. They fail to understand that lack of appreciation and gratitude signifies lack of skills in an employee, and that lack of skills results to lack of motivation to develop personality and career at the workplace. To grow professionally in one's related field and also professionally, it is very much essential to create healthy workplace relationships with peers, clients, customers, and others who are associated with the workplace. Career development can be blocked by the lack of ability to gel up with people. Employees might be at the peak of their careers, but if they show lack of essential soft skills, they may very much land onto the bottom from where they had begun. Incorporating soft skills at the workplace helps employees discover what they lack and own, their strengths and weaknesses, and how they can use it to deal with those infinite challenges and accomplish achievements that come their way during career advancement. Soft skills thus offer essential factors to influence success to the employees in reaching their career plateau. It would also be apt to mention here that a healthy mindset is very much essential to gain influence in growing. Cultivated by emotional balance, the healthy mindset is in fact the key motivator to either progress or procrastinate in career advancement. Happiness and emotional balance influence your career. Balanced people get more things done in higher quality. If you are lacking emotional balance, most of career strategies may not work for you. Studies conducted by National Business Survey from the Canadian Education and Research Institute for Counseling, CEREC, on 500 employers based on the requirement of soft skills at workplaces suggest a number of soft skills on the basis of occupation and profession, and conclude that positive attitude, communication skills, teamwork skills, and strong work ethics are few among the many skills that employers consider important. This paper studies in detail and describes the aspects of selected soft skills for career development. This paper includes positive attitude, communication skills, maintaining strong work ethics, teamwork, and time management skills to ensure a successful career development. Positive attitude. Positive attitude toward work recognizes an employee's attitude toward work. It lets the employee hold a higher degree of competence and distinction toward work. Positive attitude, in other words, is an expression that seeks personal fulfillment through reflecting and determining accomplishments. A positive attitude is one of the most important factors that influence a person's success. As it is positive attitude that determines how committed and diligent an employee is toward work, an employer would see this as helpful in career augmentation. Executed by positive thinking, positive attitude develops enthusiasm, willingness to learn, and as a result, greater appreciation of results at work. This is contagious as it influences and spreads positive energy for igniting a winning spirit for all the members in a team in particular and organization as a whole. Although knowledge and talent are essential factors to succeed, attitude interlinks both factors and enhances connectivity both with people and work. Positive thinking begins with having confidence in oneself. Confidence reinforces ability, doubles energy, buttresses mental faculties, and increases power. The beneficial impact of displaying positive attitude at the workplace has innumerable advantages of uplifting new possibilities and opportunities in terms of power and position. The right attitude consistently creates big differences, generating fine relationships which further generate better work culture and achieving goals. Right attitude is an attitude that tends to focus on the positive, are willing to work as part of a team, and strive to be a kind person. A positive-spirited environment constructs high morale and result-driven teamwork. Feeling positive and confident on both positive and negative thoughts occupy a similar space in mind. Thinking negative would result in negative feelings with obviously negative results. But practicing positive thoughts will develop a strong sense of competence that regardless of what difficulties may arise, one will be able to defeat them. Hence it is entirely on the thoughts that control attitude. Communication skills. Career development begins with good communication skills. The ability to communicate is one among the many steps to succeed in a career. Without sufficient skills to communicate, it becomes difficult to gain, hold, or enlarge interpersonal relationships, especially at workplaces. Communication is the very lifeline of workplaces that involves a large number of people associated both internally and externally with an organization. Communication binds them all. Studies believe there is considerable evidence to suggest that those who lack a range of well-developed communication skills find it difficult to advance their careers. Good communication delivers messages with clarity and responsibility to the receiver without any distortion or confusion. Hence, it is of utmost importance that the message transmitted must be efficiently spoken and fittingly listened and comprehended. Besides speaking and listening, reading and writing too are essential components of communication skills. Communication cultivates motivation. Researchers claim communication should be regarded as a transaction in which participants create meaning together in an atmosphere of trust. Communication should be such that clarifies instructions, suggestions, ideas, information, and persuasions, keeping in view that the receiver understands it. When communication is clear, employees get to know what is to be done and what more can be done to improve their performance. The goals get stimulated by desired behavior through motivation. In fact, because motivation theory is so difficult to implement, more and more companies are seeing that the link between motivation and performance improvement is communication. Communication also happens to be the main procedure to encourage and assess decision-making. Viable communication, henceforth, is a craftsmanship and thus should be incorporated at working environments for fine outcomes and achievements of objectives. Effective communication generally corrects mistake if any and provides predominant holding among everybody in the working environment and resolves clashes. Studies recommend that more than encoding, decoding the correct message is of prime significance to proceed with the communication procedure. Besides verbal method, communication can also take place non-verbally, that is, without words. According to Suzanne Jones, Associate Professor of Communication Studies at the University of Minnesota, about 65-75% of all communication is non-verbal in nature, which is why non-verbal communication forms an essential component in building successful interactions with people. One of the distinct features of non-verbal communication is that it is preeminent than verbal communication. Body language like posture, gesture, facial expression, and appearance while interacting or not interacting becomes largely pivotal during communication, especially at workplaces. Let us take, for example, if someone tends to avoid eye contact or maintains physical distance, it may clearly signify avoidance. However, it may not as well be true. There is a possibility that he or she may be an introvert. Hence, in this situation, the case is highly misjudged. Apart from body language, paralinguistic features like pitch, voice, tone, and pace also matter. A rough tone may indicate rudeness or arrogance even though not intending to. A soft voice indicates politeness, while a deep voice suggests dominance and so on. Apart from nonverbal aspects that form an essential part of communication, another essential component is assertiveness that is the result of a positive flow in our thought process to communicate well with others. Assertiveness is being responsible. Sources claim that assertive people take responsibility for expressing their opinions, and make every effort to communicate successfully even when their ideas or wishes are in conflict with the ideas of others. In fact, communication appears minuscule but is in fact a Herculean task, just as it has been ascertained that taking responsibility for each other's communication is a big task which embodies many aspects like emotions, moods, interpersonal skills and many more into its circumference. Communication becomes spontaneous and the quality and mode alter at one point. Assertiveness holds consistency and never allows any fissure in communication. Maintaining strong work ethics. Understanding ethics at the most radical level means following workplace rules that further signifies working hard, following healthy and safety rules, maintaining a clean and orderly work area and being punctual and reliable. It is of prime importance to maintain a greater level of ethics in order to grow professionally. There are instances where many people employ unethical means to get success. However, success earned through unethical means is short-lived. Being honest, stabilizing integrity, loyalty, and trust, and practicing mutual respect add value to workplace relationships and help an effective decision-making process during crucial times. Hence, ethics are mostly based on virtues and virtue ethics focused primarily on virtues or the goodness or the rightness of things, ideas, concepts, theories, or principles. Strong work ethics makes workplaces act within persistent goals, set as professional standards for behavior concerned with the welfare of the organization and also of the society. Hence, abiding by the ethical codes encourages efficient work, inspires everyone to maintain self-control, motivates employees to remain loyal to their organization, and improves quality of work. Career advancement largely depends on ascertaining core values and moving ahead to work toward a cooperative and respected culture. Teamwork. An efficient team is an asset to an organization. In fact, effective team has the ability to take more complex tasks and smooths the progress of communication by providing better space for open discussion and cooperation among team members, further maximizing the productivity of not only the team but also of the organization as a whole. Teamwork is working with people by offering the best of attitude, knowledge, and skills to other members of a team. While at the workplace, a team becomes an important place as it is a mixed bag of varying cultural backgrounds, varying perceptions, and differing ideas and opinions, but still it tends to bind its constituents together to work for a common purpose. While trying to fit in a team is a challenging task for many, it is also one of the inescapable situations at the workplace. What is even a more challenging task is failing to use team members effectively, that one can end career by ignoring the need for team development and camaraderie. Further, each member in a team is responsible to be able to carry, coordinate, and cooperate their duties along with others, because teamwork is not a group skill, rather a responsibility of each individual. Authors assertively state teamwork is about cooperating with coworkers. Apparently, being a good team leader or team member both can have enormous benefits for career advancement. Better job performance by the team would lead to better job performance of the whole organization, and the more competitive the organization, the better the chances are for job security, career advancement, salary increments, and bonuses for employees. Time management. Managing time has become one of the most important soft skills for career success and advancement. One needs to accept, grow, and go with it. There is so much to do at work, like meeting deadlines, achieving targets, delivering results, and finishing assignments, all within a time period. Hence, one has to manage time to create competence and efficacy in a way that maximizes profit, minimizes stress and frustration, and makes achieve targets more easily. In order to make a career growth, one has to sincerely make growth happen. Good, effective time management is a core skill, a career skill that we all need both to make us able to perform in a current job and to enhance our career prospects. Time management involves some great techniques that enable one to utilize time effectively and perform well in career success. Tracy surmises that knowing the value of something facilitates good time managing capability. He provides example of the executives who experience stress and get annoyed with the work given to them or with their performance. However, there are executives of other kind who put their whole heart into their work because it is a reflection of their values, seldom experience stress or burnout of any kind. With values, there emerges an intention, and that keeps the employees motivated. There is a continuous flow of energy, activeness, eagerness, and innovation in doing work, and the work flows automatically within the time frame. Effective time management enables to make good decisions and increases job satisfaction. Hence, in order to practice good time management skills and to experience paramount adequacy during career growth, business organizations strictly emphasize on effective time management ability that is a way to develop and use processes and tools for maximum efficiency, effectiveness, and productivity. It involves mastery of a set of skills like setting goals and planning and also its effective use of time to achieve desired results. The main objective of time management is to enable an individual in remaining absorbed on the activities that are important first and that matter more than other things or activities, thus helping an individual being aware of how to use time as one resource in organizing, prioritizing, and succeeding in a business in the context of all the competing activities of startups and new ventures. Introduction. Nowadays, organizations are facing a lot of challenges when competing in various sectors of the global market such as economics, technology, and labor. One of the crucial strategies for an organization to gain competitive advantage is exploitation of training. In particular, training is an important function for an organization to cultivate employees' explicit and implicit knowledge, skills, and abilities and transfer employees into the valuable resources of an organization. This function is not only linked to improvement of business performance but also an effective determinant in shaping employee attitudes, which are critical variables to influence job performance. According to the literature, job satisfaction is defined as a pleasurable emotional state resulting from the appraisal of one's job or job experiences, p. 94. It is one of the major job attitudes to affect employees' behaviors and shows a strong relationship with other effective outcomes such as learning motivation, turnover rate, and firm performance. Since training and job satisfaction are two important variables which individually produces impacts on firm performance, this lecture aims to elaborate training and organization toward job satisfaction. This lecture is organized in four sections. The first section describes how to plan and carry out an effective training program. It begins by discussing the definition of training and the meaning of learning. Next, a training effectiveness model is constructed to present a whole picture about the factors which influence the training outcomes. Elucidation will be provided for each part of the model, which includes individual characteristics, organizational characteristics, and task characteristics, followed by needs assessment, training design, and training evaluation. The second section focuses on job satisfaction, in which the fundamental concepts are introduced. This is followed by discussion of the impacts of job satisfaction on job performance. The third section describes job training satisfaction and how it contributes to job satisfaction, job performance, and other work-related attitudes. The final section is conclusions. Training? What is training? Training refers to a planned effort by a company to facilitate employees' learning of job-related competencies, p. 5. It is also defined as a planned and systematic effort to modify or develop knowledge, skills, and attitudes through learning experiences to achieve effective performance in an activity or a range of activities, p. 41. Training is the major means to be used by organizations to cultivate employee competence to reach the appropriate required levels. It is also an important business strategy for organizations to cope with a variety of forces affecting the workplace. It is stated that training is organized and used by an organization as a business strategy to help employees develop and acquire competence, which includes knowledge, skills, behaviors, and attitudes that are critical for successful job performance. Typically, training can be distinguished by two basic types of locations where it is conducted, i.e., off the job and on the job. Off the job training provides learning opportunities on a variety of topics at a site other than where the work is actually done, whereas on-the-job training, OJT, occurs in the work setting itself. With the assistance of modern technology, online training can be realized as well. No matter which sites or ways the training is conducted, the key to effective training is to activate learning to occur. In most of the text courses, learning is defined as an effect of experience on behavior. It is related to a process of change in behavior that is due to experience. Actually, all learning involves two processes. One is an external interaction process between the learner and his or her social, cultural, and material environment, and the other is an internal psychological process of elaboration and acquisition in which new impulses are connected with the results of prior learning. However, if the outputs of learning process, either through external or internal, only produce change in people's behavior, such a definition cannot be satisfied by many researchers. Therefore, learning has also been defined as a relatively permanent change in human capabilities that is not a result of growth processes, p. 140. Based on this definition, learning can bring out three different outcomes. The first one is the content dimension, which refers to knowledge, understanding, skills, abilities, and attitudes. The second one is the incentive dimension, which includes emotion, feelings, motivation, and volition. The final one is the social dimension, which involves interaction, communication, and cooperation. Learning, thus, can be further referred to as a process that is seen through changes in knowledge, skills, attitudes, behaviors, emotion managing ability, communication style, and more during training and generalization to the transfer context. Traditionally, in the workplace, learning occurs through formal training and development. All formal learning activities are designed with specific learning objectives to cultivate employees in lifelong processes for ongoing development and acquisition of competencies to meet the challenges that the organization faces from its internal and external environment. Typically, such learning is activated through direct instruction, which engage learners in lectures, discussions, simulations, role plays, and other structured activities. With technological advancement and intense competition, training scholars have claimed that employees must extend their learning outside the formal classroom or work settings to ensure competencies are maximized. Thus, informal learning becomes important because it represents the most part of learning occurring in organizations. Watkins and Marsick characterized informal learning as a process based on learning from experience, embedded in the organizational context, oriented to a focus on action, governed by non-routine conditions, concerned with tacit dimensions that must be made explicit, delimited by the nature of the task, the way in which the problems are framed, and the work capacity of the individual underlying the task, and enhanced by proactivity, critical reflectivity, and creativity, p. 287. It is unstructured and occurs outside a learning institution. Shows the relationships between training and learning. Training, either off the job, on the job, or online, involves transferring expertise and knowledge from experts who have it to novices who need it. Both training and learning activities consist of a process of knowledge sharing, which is an element of reciprocity and is a giving-taking exchange process of information or assistance to others. Knowledge sharing between employees and across teams allows an organization to exploit existing knowledge-based resources and has been identified as a positive force in creating innovative organizations. The relationships between training and learning. In a competitive environment, while employee training and learning have become an increasingly important strategic issue for organizations, the core concern is how to help the company and trainees receive benefits from the training activities. The related questions include what kind of factors that may affect the success and effectiveness of training and what/how trainers can do to make training program effective. Training effectiveness, according to Noe, p. 216, refers to the benefits that the company and trainees receive from training. It focuses on understanding the whole learning system to determine why learners learn or do not. It also explains why the learning results happen and assists training designers to make troubleshooting to improve training. Thus, theoretically, training effectiveness is the study of the individual, training, and organizational characteristics that influence the training process before, during, and after training. Training effectiveness differs from the training evaluation. Training effectiveness is a theoretical approach to understand learning outcomes, whereas training evaluation is a methodological approach to measure these learning outcomes. A summarized model of training effectiveness is presented in shows the factors that impact the training outcomes and job performance and the relationships between them. Three major topics will be discussed, that is, needs assessment before training, shaded with gray color, program design and delivery during training, shaded with orange color, and training evaluation after training, shaded with pink color. The comprehensive model of training effectiveness. Effective training practices involving the use of a training design process begin with a needs assessment. A need is a measurable gap between two conditions, what currently is and what should be. In order to define the gap of need in training, a complete assessment process should be conducted to figure out problem areas, issues, or difficulties that should be resolved. Thus, A training needs assessment refers to the process used to determine whether training is necessary and why specific training activities are required. In most contexts, a needs assessment focuses on gaps rather than solutions. Theoretically, it involves three levels of analysis: organizational analysis, person analysis, and task analysis. Organizational characteristics, individual characteristics, and task characteristics are factors to be considered for three levels of analysis in the beginning of training design. The purpose of these levels of analysis is to realize the gaps in current training programs and further to collect information for program design and problem solving. N. The first factor is organizational characteristics. Organizational characteristics include organizational structure, business strategies, support of managers for training activities, training resources, organizational procedures, reward systems, culture, and climate. Each variable plays a very critical role to impact training effectiveness. For example, Fatoa et al. Found that intrinsic and compliance incentives, organizational commitment, and social support for training are able to predict trainees' pre-training motivation. Motivation is the key determinant of the choices individuals make to engage in, attend to, and persist in learning activities, which will affect learning performance. Because organizational analysis is concerned with identifying whether, 1, training fits the company's strategic objectives, 2, training supports the company's culture, climate, and policies, and, 3, the company has the budget, time, and expertise to carry out training, this analysis is usually conducted in the first place. Several major questions will be assessed in this analysis. How does the training relate to business objectives? How does training support business strategy? What are the threats to the talent base? How does the training impact day-to-day workplace dynamics? What are the costs and expected benefits of the training? Another factor, individual characteristics, includes cognitive ability, attitudes, locus of control, personality, anxiety, age, self-efficacy, expectations, job involvement, pre-training motivation, need for achievement, independence, and more. A large number of studies have been demonstrating how individual differences influence transfer of learning and learning performance, which further impacts on training effectiveness.